Football is a game fought over dividing lines. The yard lines, the scrimmage line, the goal line, and the unseen line that splits the Buckeye Wolverine shop in Maumee, Ohio. Scarlet and gray on one side, maize and blue on the other, and never the twain shall meet.
There's absolutely no way to intermingle these items together. You literally have customers come in that will not walk on the other side.
This line defines the binary nature of one of college football's most deep-seated rivalries.
One gentleman I walk up to, I said, anything I can help you with? And he said, well, you could do one thing for me. Get rid of all that blue stuff. I had a Michigan fan come up to me, same exact thing. You could get rid of all that red stuff.
It's an either-or world. Either you wear blue or red. Either you refer to Michigan as that team up north, or to Ohio State as Ohio. Either you buy your gas in Michigan or you don't. According to legend, Ohio State coach Woody Hayes refused to stop for gas in Michigan on recruiting trips, even once ordering his assistant to push his car a mile to the first filling station in Ohio. Hayes so hated Michigan that in 1968, he went for two after a late touchdown gave Ohio State a 50-14 lead. My only regret, Hayes said, was that I couldn't go for three. The next year, Michigan hired Bo Schembechler, one of Hayes' former players and assistants. Bo beat Woody 24-12, the last time the Wolverines beat a number one ranked Buckeyes team. It was the start of the 10-year war between the two legends. As Hayes said then, I didn't like that SOB when he played for me, I didn't like him when he worked for me, and I certainly don't like him now. The dividing lines run deep, and when they do get crossed, the story sounds like something out of a Nathan Hale bio or a John Le Carré novel. It begins with Mike Boren, a linebacker who grew up in Columbus, but chose to play at Michigan for Schembechler instead of at Ohio State for Earl Bruce.
The coach didn't think I was good enough to play at Ohio State, so Michigan was recruiting me, and Bo told me he never let me forget about it.
Mike played at Michigan from 1980 to 83. His future wife ran track there. More than 50 schools recruited their firstborn son, Justin, an offensive lineman.
I was going to choose between Ohio State or Michigan. Those were my top two schools and the only two schools I had ever thought about going to.
Justin chose to play for Lloyd Carr at Michigan. That made everybody happy in the Boren house, including his younger brother, Zach.
We grew up massive Michigan fans. I wore maize and blue to school every single day. Definitely hated the Buckeyes.
When Michigan replaced Carr with Rich Rodriguez, Justin wanted out. He became only the third player to leave Michigan for Ohio State, the first since World War II.
I know people think it's kind of crazy. It's, you know, obviously a huge rivalry, but for me, it was the only other school that I had ever considered going to.
There was only one choice. So basically, it was play for Ohio State, you know? It was tough. I mean, it was tough.
3 days later, I cleaned out my entire wardrobe with my mom, threw away all the maize and blue, and a little over a month later, I committed to play football at Ohio State.
A third son of Michigan parents, Jacoby Boren, also wound up playing for Ohio State.
There's just something about Ohio State that, and I can't really quite explain it, that just sets it apart from Michigan.
Jacoby won a national title under Urban Meyer, who went 7-0 against that team up north. Reputations, for better or worse, are made in this game.
It's one of those things where when you have such a hate for someone and you're in that moment where you're with that person or with that thing, it's an all-out fist fight.
It all began with one disputed line. The line between Michigan and Ohio. In that Toledo strip, a rivalry was born. Andrew Jackson settled the border war 184 years ago. But the battle between Michigan and Ohio State over 1.3 acres of turf knows no end. This year, they meet for the 116th time. Somebody will win, somebody will lose. But the very nature of a rivalry this ineradicable is that nothing is ever settled. Every year, every game, every snap, every hit, every run, every pass, every hard-fought yard is a referendum on which side of the line you stand. Maize and blue, or scarlet and gray. The line between only grows deeper.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoy that clip, make sure you click subscribe somewhere down here. From game highlights to exclusive interviews and rankings, we've got everything you need as a college football fan right here, College Football on Fox.